Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new guide for Russian Fishing 4. And in this video I'm going to show you guys how you need to get a fish, a very big fish, with low level gear. So with a low test. So the thing is, I got a lot of questions about guys, they are in the Winding River and they want to go to Old Borg, so to Old Fort. And the thing is, they always ask me, can I go to there? And I always say, no, you cannot go to there, or you need to do this. And this is what I'm going to explain in this video. So the thing is, if you want to go to Old Borg, you need to have this reel. You cannot go, and this, the Siberia Saber 60S, and even with this reel, you are going to get spooled a lot of time, because it's only 10 kilogram test. So you can go to 20 kilogram offline, but that's not enough. Because there are fish that are 25 kilograms, 20 kilograms, and you need to know that you always need to divide the weight of the fish, or double the weight of the fish, and then that's what you can get in with that line. So if I got a fish of 9 kilograms, I already going to have trouble to get him in. So the thing is, what you can do, it's very easy. So the thing is, it's the same with Fishing Planet that we have at the start. So you need to have a reel. And you just stack up a lot of line. That's the trick. So you are going to fight that fish for a long time, but you can get, I think, every fish in the game. You can get that in, but it's going to take you hours and hours. But that's the only way that you can get it in with low level gear. I don't saw one guy that got with low level gear with only 100 meter line that he got a carp in of 15 kilograms. I don't think that's possible. Maybe it's possible, but I don't think so. If you are very lucky, it's possible. But I'm going to show you guys what you need to know about the reels, because there is info on the reels, but you need to understand what that info means. So I'm going now to the shop and I'm going to show you guys a very low level gear, a reel. So let's go to the reels. Here you guys see the reels, and I use this reel the whole time. I think this is the reel that you need to have. I'm not sure this is going to work. It will work too, but it's such a crap reel that that's unbelievable that you're ever going to get a fish within. I'm not saying it doesn't work, but I'm going to start with this one and I'm going to use this as a benchmark, because I use that a lot. So if you click on a reel, you got here info. And here the size is very important. So the size, that means how big your reel is. So that means how much line that you can stack on that reel. So you are going to see that very high stars quality reels always going to have a very big size, because you can stack a lot of line on it. That's what gives a difference in price most of the time. So what is important? So you see line capacity. What does that mean? So it's very easy. So if you see 0.2 millimeter, like this one, you can stack 245 meter on that reel. So I always say you need to have above 200 meters to not get spooled. I'm not saying if you stand still that you cannot get spooled, because the fish can swim all the way away, but you need to run after it, but you are going to get the fish in. That's what I say. So if you want to get 0.2 millimeter on this rod, or this reel, sorry, it's going to give you 245 meters. So that's what you need to do, guys. If you go to 0.24 millimeter, it's going to give you only 181 meters. So of course, the thicker the line, the less line that you can stack on a reel. That's normal, because the volume is, yeah, limited on a reel. So that's very important. To give you guys an example, so people always ask me, what do I need to buy? So here you got the Cyber 40 and the Cyber 60. You guys already can see what's the difference, the size. Okay, the ratio is a little bit different too. So that's one turn around with your reel, how much distance you make. So globally set, how fast your reel is going to go. So sometimes it's important, but I never found that really important, because it depends what presentation that you want to do with spinning. If you want to do a very quick stop and go, or if you want to twitch or something like that, then it's important. But most of the time, yeah, I never look to a reel on the gear ratio, to be honest. And I play already a couple of fishing games for a long time. So what is the difference? The size. But if I click now on the Saber 40S, you guys will see the first line capacity is 0.2 millimeter, 260 meter. If I go now to the Saber 60S, you will see that the first one is 0.28 millimeter, 207 meter. That means the line is thicker, and I go 200 meters too. So the fish is coming a lot quicker, yeah, in. So that's most of the time the difference between reels. They look the same, but they are not the same. Because the thing is, it's very important that you got a lot of line. So for the guys that saw my trophy pike that I just caught here, I got a bread line, and it's like 200 meters just for that. Because that fish swims to the other side of the area, and I cannot get behind it. Okay, so what you need to do now is... So you need to do a very high investment, because you need to buy 350 meters of line. So, for example, if you go to this reel, so let's say we want around 200 meters. Okay, it's going to be between 0.2 and 0.24. Then you need to go to the lines. And then you need to go to here. So let's go to the cheapest one. I'm not going to buy it because silver is way too expensive. And I need 5,000 to get my new reel. So if you want to check out, so it was 0. So this one is very close. So if you're going to stack this one, you are going to get more than 200, what was it, 30 meters. But it's 41 silver. If you're going to stack this one, you're going to get a little bit less. So you can do this one, but of course this one got a test of 5 kilograms. That means that the fight is not going to take that long. That's simple. Because you are now going to stack a very low line on that reel, and you are going to fish for fish sometimes 12 to 14, 15 kilograms. So you need to imagine that's 3-4 times your line. So that's what you need to do, guys. So you can stack this or you can stack that. But it's expensive. You guys can see it's not cheap. It's 41 silver, but it's worth it. And that's the only way, in my opinion, how you can get a big fish in the fourth lake or somewhere else. So that's how you need to do it. So that's the trick that I say to a lot of people. In my video, how you need to make a good setup, I said it too. But I think a lot of people didn't saw it. So that's it, guys. That's all the things that you need to know. A very important tip too is, guys, I tested a lot of times the bread line on feeders. And it's ridiculous. So never use bread line on feeders. It's crazy. The wear off with bread on feeders, I did it to make the same trick that I got now, so to get a lot of line on the reel. So, and I did it, so if you throw in, you do damage to 0.1% already. If you reel back in, you are going to do once again 0.1 damage. So, throwing in, reeling back in, only without getting one fish, if you put braid on a feeder, is 0.2 damage percentage. So that means if you do 10 casts, you are going to get already damage around 2%. So it's ridiculous. It's crazy how much damage a feeder, I think it's the mess feeder or something, I'm not sure, do on breadline. So don't use it, guys, because it's going to be so fast fucked up. You never can make your money back. So I think they put it in the game, otherwise it's very easy. You just get the bread line, you put it on, you take a very high test, and you got 200 meters and you got the 28 test on your rod. So I think they prevent it. So I'm going to put it in my last beginner guide too. Never put bread on a feeder. So that was it a little bit, guys. So a quick reminder, if you get reel and you are low level, under the 10 kilogram of the saber, and you go to Old Fort, just check this. Get for sure 200 meter on your line and you will be okay. You are going to fight some fish for 1-2 hours real life. But yeah, that's how it is, guys. I cannot change that. So that was the guide a little bit. Have fun. Be always careful if you do stuff like that. Yeah, now... Yeah, there is not a lot that can go wrong. But be sure that your drag is not very high. If you got a new setup, be sure that your lines are not that long in the water. Don't go away from your lines and you will be okay. There are a lot of videos on the YouTube already from guys that got with low level setup a very high fish in kilograms. So that was it. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like the video, give me a like. If you like my channel, subscribe, please. Have fun in Russian Fishing 4. Bye-bye.